So the big story is the cuts, the NXT cuts that happened today. So I will name everybody, and then we can talk about the why part of this. So the biggest name was Bronson Reed. He also had Bobby Fish, Mercedes Martinez, Leon Ruff, Tyler Rust, who is actually on the TV show right now.
Yeah, he's Diamond Mine, the group that just started.
Jake Atlas, Ari Sterling, who is
Alex Zane,
Kona Reeves, Zechariah Smith, Asher Hale, Giant Zangier, Stefan Smith, and Denzel Desjardins, who is Desmond Troy.
Yeah.
So out of those, I think, like I said, the big name was Bronson Reed. Like, that's the one that kind of kicked this whole thing off. And it was just like a WTF when I read that name.
Yeah, and that was a surprise for sure.
And Fish, you know, Fish is a big name, but he's also kind of without a group right now. But the rest of them, what did you think about the rest of them? Because they...
Most of them were guys that... Like, some of them were guys that people don't even know. They're not even on TV anymore. Kona Reeves, who had spurts of TV, but they hadn't used it in a long time. And, you know, at the end of the day, those guys, most of the guys that got cut, it was like, you know, they were never going to help the company. So it's not a surprise or anything like that. Ari Sterling or Alex Zane is very talented. And... giving up on him so quick, I think that's probably an age thing. I think Bobby Fish is an age thing. Bronson Reed's not a young guy either, actually. And obviously, you know, like 2 weeks ago, they were considering for the main roster. Mm-hmm. And I think Vince maybe, you know, whatever it is, Vince is Vince, and maybe Vince just didn't like his look and
accent. It was
just like, and now that he saw him. You know, and people were pushing him and everything like that. It's a Vince call. We, you know, and all these are Vince calls. You know, I mean, people, you know, it's amusing to me watching people put the blame on Nick Khan. I mean, it's almost like a joke. You know, I mean, this is Vince. And it's always Vince.
Nick probably is not in tune with who these guys even are, right?
He's not making decisions on who they cut. He may make decisions on budget cuts, but not on who they cut. And certainly, you know, again, the salaries of these guys is not, I mean, these are not super highly paid guys. It's not like Braun Strowman or Ric Flair or Bray Wyatt. Those are big time money players. I mean, they're very expensive guys. So you could argue whatever on those guys, but the point is like, this is, you know, it's just downsizing NXT because they have too many people there. Mm-hmm. Than they can use, and a lot of the guys, you know, once you're 35 and you're not on the main roster, you're kind of not really a prospect anymore. Vince wants bigger guys, although obviously Bronson Reed got cut, and he wants younger guys, and they want to bring in younger guys, and they've got younger guys. They got a bunch of younger guys that they've just picked up that are very good athletes. Of course, they've really not done well with good athletes of late, but whatever. So there's going to be guys cut. And I think, age is obviously the Bobby Fish thing. And then, you know, Atlas, you know, you could watch their TV and you could see that, like, basically every single thing that Jake Atlas did that got him over, they've told him not to do. So, you know, once you do that, you know, you're...
Except for the finish. They let him keep his finish.
They did let him keep the finish. That's true. But he doesn't get to beat anybody with it. I mean, in the sense of, it wasn't like he was getting any kind of a meaningful push, and they didn't see him as a star or anything. So, and Mercedes Martinez is another one where I'm sure that's an age issue as well. So, you know, I mean, yeah, just without Alex Zane, I thought, you know, just whatever. It was too quick. Jake Atlas, I was surprised by Jake, but you know, it's not like they booked him strong. Bobby Fish, I was a little surprised, but at the same time, when you think about it, I wasn't that surprised either. And you know, Kona Reeves, you know, they don't use him. Denzel Desjardins, in the sense of, he's a good athlete, but They got a lot of good athletes, and you know, it doesn't shock me. He wasn't being used either. You know, Tyler Rust surprised me just because they just started the diamond mine thing, and it's, you know, whatever. It just shows that, like, if nothing else, it shows that the guy who's making the decision, which is Vince, doesn't care about cohesiveness on their TV. But we've seen that before too. You know, this isn't the first time that cuts have done that too, you know.
How involved would Triple H be in these?
He's got to be involved some way. He's got to be. But I don't know. I don't know, like, who's making the calls. You know, I don't know. But he has to be in those meetings. There's no way he's running NXT. So, you know, and they'd have to defer to him because he's the one who knows it. So that's why I'm surprised that there's guys that he was actually using, especially the diamond mine thing. But they haven't really pushed the diamond mine like crazy. And the Hit Row is more of the new group that's really getting over, not the diamond mine. So if they were not like a, you know, they really weren't like being groomed. They lost their second weekend. They're not really being groomed to be this great thing. It was just, you know, a group. So, but still, it surprised me.
Okay, so. You, when NXT went to USA, you immediately said they were there to play defense for Dynamite.
Yes.
The fact that they lost that war, do you think that opened up Vince's eyes to what this product is? And now it's got his attention, which is probably a very bad thing for the product, for NXT.
I don't think it's like that.
The people who run NXT.
I don't think it's like that, but absolutely. Absolutely, there's no doubt that Vince did not pick a fight to lose, and they lost bad. You know, nobody will say it, but they did. And not, you know, everything that we talked about as to what would happen if and when they lost and moved days is now happening. So it's and I don't think that they truly believed it, but I mean. If you followed it, you would know. If you watched the numbers, you would know what was going to happen. There were enough hints anyway. So somebody's got to take the blame. And I think that, you know, if you're in the company, and I know this, you know, people in the company, it's like, it's Paul's baby, and they lost. They, you know, they were put in a fight to win, and they got their ass kicked. And, you know, he was a losing general. And it's like, you know, you may like the product. The takeovers are great and all that. And whatever, but you know, you're going to be, the results are what the results are, and I am sure that that plays into everything that's happening.
Hey, if you're a big fan of Wrestling Observer Radio, we got 12,000 episodes of all of our podcasts up at our website, wrestlingobserver.com. If you sign up today, you get access to every single one of them. The 12 to 18 new shows that we do every single week, you can podcast them, listen to them on the road, at work, working out, in the shower, wherever you listen to your podcasts, and also full access to the Wrestling Observer newsletter and archives. So if you love what you hear, head to WrestlingObserver.com. 12,000 audio shows at your fingertips.